we're willing to accept those negative consequences, such as deterioration of our bodies, in order to achieve these new perspectives. It's not elitism, but it's at least stratification, where I'm deciding, okay, yeah, some people prioritize stability and safety and comfort over any new experiences. Right, these are different value systems. I don't think that they should be behaving like me. I don't want them to behave like me. They can do whatever they want. I'm not telling anyone what to do. I'm just doing what I want to do and leading by example. Their good, which is comfort, stability, and financial security, are absolutes that we should all be striving for. I guess it gives them comfort in the face of meaninglessness. And we're able to confront meaninglessness and say, fine, this existence means nothing objectively. So we're going to make it as beautiful, or at least as dramatic as possible. We're not trying to make decisions for multitudes of people. We're all so intensely focused on traumatizing our own struggle.
At what point did you have your dummy taken with?
I'm kind of willing to endure a certain degree of discomfort and a huge degree of instability in my life in order to reach new heights, have new experiences. I don't challenge myself if I'm flatlining.
I don't want to know what's going to happen in 5 years.
Yeah, this sea monkey is so profound. So profound.
They died so soon. I didn't even have a time to name them. I didn't even get time to name them.
You didn't have time to count them. I don't need another life. This is it.
Same thing.
I'll be exhausted. I'm already exhausted. Personally, I can achieve and produce nothing in that state. When I'm in that state, complete and utter despair or depression or devastation or panic, I'm unable to achieve revelation or a new idea. A new vision, a new understanding of my own behavior, or my own life, my own existential state. I personally always experience those things, and then through either conversation or self-overhearing, I'm able to.
I used to think I was kidding myself that I was always at my most creative when I was most at my lowest. But actually, it's a different. I'm kind of in the middle, but more towards the same as you, where it's coming from that joyous art feeling of sharing it with someone that you know, us, for example. The dramatizing is the darkest point, and then that's you knock it off and suddenly people get an idea.
When I'm in that state, I cannot see any comedy. I can't see any musical tragedy. I can't see any aestheticism. Then in conversation, we're able to recognize those elements in the event. And thus, discharge it of a certain kind of taboo or trauma. Lean into it and dramatize it, make it kind of useful and extreme and massive, tragic fulcrum or dramatic fulcrum around outreach to like social event venues.
Yeah.
It takes a while. You slowly expose yourself and expose yourself and expose yourself. And then suddenly, oh, it's like discharged. Like it will get there. You just have to be able to like constantly perform it. Like, because then you're able to, in that moment of tragedy, inject some kind of meaning or beauty. Eventually you get to that state, and once that happens, you're free. Just like in the Tower of the Person, I'm like, they're halfway between two worlds. Like, you're not aware of what the change is gonna be. The tower is struck by lightning, the person falls. In some images of the cars, it looks like the person is committing suicide. Or like fleeing a burning tower. But like, it's a narrow escape, passing a threshold.
Yeah.
And like, the way to pass that threshold is by, for example, continually confronting it. But the thing is, you're able to see. Slowly you get to a point where there's enough space between you and the trauma, you're able to like inject it with meaning or some kind of value or beauty. We all dress and look like ill, mad people when we go out. Because those are things that we actually battle with. And like, we save ourselves from it by constantly making it beautiful.
It was like when I first met you, like nasal cannula up to the eyebrows.
Exactly.
And now I'm popular! I'm through it now. I'm over forums.
Through the eyes.
Back to the books.
Perfect. I'm gonna go back to the perfect.